So now, as per schedule, we'll actually start watching plotting histogram and pie chart, that tutorial. And then next we'll be plotting bar chart and scatter plot. So you have to finish these two tutorials in 1 hour time. We are giving you half an hour for each tutorial so that you can do it thoroughly. Try to do everything, whatever in the tutorial, and don't do assignment. We are, as you know, we are going to give you practice problems separately. And we have uploaded day two practice problems, problem in the folder. If you get time, try to finish that as well. Dr. Shailaja, you have any question?
No, ma'am, actually, yesterday I couldn't attend the after 5 o'clock. I think I wrote that due to some climatic condition or I don't know what. So there was networking problem, network problem. Mm-hmm. So that's why I don't know what was that.
Homework.
How we have to submit the assignment and all this.
No, you don't have to submit any assignment.
Okay.
This is for your own practice. If you face any problem, we are here to help you.
Okay.
You have to query anything. You just have to do the practice problems as well so that not only watching and because along with the tutorial, if you are doing, you will get it. But if you are doing independently, we just want to see how confident you are.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Sure. I'm doing that too.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So that you will get some confidence once you are doing on your own things, then you will remember even commands, those. So at least some basic commands you should learn, definitely.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
So let's go back now, and then you can do two tutorials, histogram and then scatter plot. So now, is there anybody who has not downloaded CD link yet? Or installed RStudio. Because some people have joined yesterday in the second session afternoon. So this is to those 10 participants who have joined later. Dr. Purnima and their team. So I hope you have completed earlier tutorials as well as afternoon thing. Okay, so please, actually, we can meet at 11:30 again. And we are there to answer all your questions on forum, post your questions on forum. If any other problem which is not relevant to spoken, you can post it in the chat window. Okay. Yeah, we'll meet again at 11:30.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay. I hope everybody has completed two tutorials without any problem because we didn't see any questions in the forum. I hope everybody is referring even instruction sheet which is shared with you to refer while you do the spoken tutorials. Okay. So now, as per schedule, next, now we'll move on to ggplot2. ggplot2 is another package, separate package for plotting. So you need to do two tutorials available in the spoken: introduction to ggplot2 and aesthetic mapping in ggplot2. You have any question for related to plot or anything? We can take actually a few questions for 5-10 minutes and then we can go ahead.
Excuse me, ma'am. Can you please repeat the two videos name which you have just now said?
Yeah, it is mentioned in the schedule also: introduction to ggplot2, aesthetic mapping in ggplot2. There are two tutorials available in spoken related to ggplot2. Those two you have to do it. Can you locate it? You have CD link shared with you, right? You have downloaded all the videos.
Yes, yes.
Okay. It's tutorial 17 and 18.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, while doing histogram, did all the bars in histogram, we can do some curve like linear or logarithmic curve. Which curve? that things how can we do, ma'am, in R?
Okay, Digviji, you want to answer? Yeah, we can do linear curve.
That bell shape, that shape, how we can get in R?
Yeah. So linear curve we can do.
So there is a function with the name curve, C-U-R-V-E. I'm typing it in the chat itself. This can be used to create custom curves in R.
Okay.
So there is one function with the name lines. Also, if you want to add some specific line to the existing plot, and in the upcoming live session, I'll show you how you can create that bell-shaped curves also.
Okay, sir.
It's a part of a normal distribution.
Yes.
It's bell-shaped. So I think you are talking about normal distribution. So that will be in the live session.
Okay, sir.
Right. So meanwhile, you can look at the help section for curve lines by simply putting a question mark like this. So you'll get a detail of this function, also with some examples to try out.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
All right.
Ma'am, how can we add custom color to the sections of pie chart? In the tutorial, we added orange color to all the sections. But how can we add color to a specific section?
Yeah, Digvijay?
Yes, so you need to first, you can add different colors. If you go to the help section of this pie chart by writing this and scrolling down, then you will see that various examples are there of pie chart itself. For example, like this. So you need to pass the colors in the COL parameter. But you need to first know how many sections you have. So this will basically color from the first section to the last, given the order of colors you pass into the COL parameter. So you need to first know.
Afternoon, sir. हाँ सर, मैं बेसिकली एक चीज़ पूछना चाह रहा था कि हम हेल्प में जाके ये चीज़ें देख सकते हैं, कोई एनी अदर बुक रिलेटेड टू इट इन विच वी कैन फाइंड ऑल द बेसिक ये
प्लॉटिंग
हाँ यस सर. We want to modify something, so we have to every time we have to find out from the help, and it is having some examples also. But if you want to have some book like we have in Excel or Word, like this, any book you can refer us for our.
Okay, so yes, there is a book. I'm sharing it. I think it's open source also. There's no need to buy it online. This one. So this is regarding the ggplot. Yes, this is regarding ggplot and other curves also. So there are a number of books. If you just simply type books on data visualization using R, then you will get a number of books which are already there. So it is not only limited to just plots. There are maps also. And there are various plots for statistical models also. So you can refer to this book. You can just click on the name, click on this link. It will get you to the book. Okay, I will type the name of the book also. It is Data Visualization with R by Rob Kabakoff. And the link is, this is the link. Anything else?
One more thing, sir, when we are doing this bar chart in the spoken tutorial, it is very much perfect, but in my system it is somewhat not aligned straight line. So is it with my system problem or something else?
Straight line, actually. Is it possible if you can share your screen and let me see how you are getting it?
1 minute, ma'am. I'm somewhat forward. I have to go back to that bar plot.
Yeah, fine. We can wait. Meantime, any other question we can take up?
ma'am, what is the use of last command, meaning last equals to two? What is this two doing?
Did you get with Digvijay? Can you answer?
Yes, ma'am. You're getting this parameter loss in which function?
In bar plot.
In bar plot. Okay. Actually, there are a number of parameters associated with a single function. So you can do one thing. You can write it in the forums and I'll get back to you.
Okay. Thank you.
What is the use of this last function, last parameter in the bar plot function, and I'll get back to you.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, this pie chart, in this these lines are not correctly aligned, but in the tutorial it is perfectly aligned. So is it my system problem or something else?
Correctly aligned as in?
Sir, this inbuilt circle line radius lines are correctly aligned in a straight line. But when we want to use it as in JPJ format or other, these are not perfectly aligned, right, sir? But in the tutorial, it is perfectly. So it is my system problem or something else?
No. It's not a problem, actually. It's when you zoom in, these lines, you see this kind of shakiness in the line. This is not a problem.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
It's not
sir.
A problem. This is a kind of a limitation you see in the plot, basic plots of R, basic graphics library of R. That's why we mostly recommend grammar of graphics, ggplot.
Okay, sir.
Any other question?
Excuse me?
Yes.
I have a problem that my pie chart is very, very small.
Okay.
So what should I do to make it?
Can you please post your code in the forum?
Okay, I will do it.
Yes.
Any other question? So can we move on and then start with the next two tutorials, which is the introduction to ggplot2 and aesthetic mapping in ggplot2. So we'll meet again at 12:45 and discuss the same. If you have any question, we'll take up before lunch. So we'll okay. 1 o'clock lunch break. We'll meet again at 12:45. Till 1, we'll take all the questions and then we can again take a lunch break. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Are you finding it interesting now? Now that you know programming?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Slowly, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, this is what the good part of spoken is. Slowly you will gain confidence and basically you will learn very slow. Pace is very slow. We show each and every command, each and every click, where we have to go, where do you have to do what exactly, so that you will be comfortable in that environment. Our environment will be comfortable. Okay, so we'll meet again at 12:45. Thank you. Okay, those who have joined, do you have any question related to the last two spoken tutorials which we have done?
Ma'am, in the second tutorial, aesthetics one at 4:40, I am not getting the same result at 4:40 minutes of the video.
Okay. So can you post the question in forum?
Okay, ma'am.
What you are, take a screenshot of that thing and you can post it.
Okay.
Error, just post that error with the details. Is that okay? Because we won't be able to understand exactly what you're talking right now.
Okay.
Any other question?
Ma'am, in first tutorial, introduction to ggplot2, when I'm trying to run the view movies, that means movie data frame, all the data should be displayed, but there is error in view movies, couldn't find function movie view. error in view movies semicolon could not find function view. This written. I have installed the package ggplot2 and it is displayed in the top left corner also of the window, but I don't know why this command is not running.
Okay, Digvijay, can you answer?
Yes, ma'am. So just make sure that view, the first letter is capital.
Okay, sir. I'm just checking.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the problem, I think.
Yes, ma'am.
You can try and see.
Yes, ma'am. Just 2 minutes. Yes, sir. It is open now. Thank you.
Right.
Any other queries?
Actually, a similar query like mine has been posted there, but the answer is not good enough.
Mm-hmm.
So shall I post the question again or shall I add comment in the
video? Digvijay, if he shares the screen, will you be able to answer the question?
So Mr. Lokesh, have you posted your question there already? No, it has been actually Juhi. One Juhi has already asked the same question. I am facing the same problem only. Okay. So is it fulfilling your problem? Your no, the answer is not like answer. Just saying that okay, it should be like this ideally. But like see in the string and level command, like we are getting you know instead of factor with level 6 and all those things. Instead of that. I'm getting CHR, then bracket 1 colon 600. And then in the levels, I'm getting null. Okay. You can post it in the forum. Okay.
Any other question related to plotting or any general question, if you have any, if you are curious to know, not related to spoken, but any other general query. So anybody has attempted a practice problem? Did you get time to do that? Anybody raise your hand. Mr. Venkatesh, have you attempted the problem?
No, ma'am. I have some doubts related to you asked some general doubts, right?
Yes, sir. You can.
Ma'am, how we can how we can enhance all those plots, ma'am? Because sometimes that x-axis text should be inclined, or sometimes the gap between the individual bar, we can increase the gap between individual bar. How we can enhance, is there any methods or the book which was referred by sir, the details will be available there or not? Is there any techniques to enhance our output?
Did you get a chance to see additional material wherever we provide? Did you get a chance to see that? Did you see that? Sometimes some additional material with the spoken tutorial.
Yes, ma'am, in bottom right corner.
Correct. Okay. So sometimes we try to give extra information along with tutorial, which we may not be able to cover in 10 minutes. So we actually ask participants to read more about those things. So for that, we give additional material. So like that, sometimes we give, sometimes actually, you know, R is open source. So there are so many contributors to increase the thing for the R. So there are many contributors who are actually helping in improving different features in R. So what is happening? So if you just Google, suppose some particular thing, if you want to do, you can just Google it. In fact, you may find some similar answer and that way you can try it.
Okay.
Yeah. So because a lot of things are available online for R, it's a huge community and people are contributing in different ways. So Google whatever your requirement is, and there are a lot of functions, lot of things available, lot of features available. So it is very difficult to for any programmer to remember those things, you know. So what generally is a good practice is you can Google whatever command you have to use or feature you want to use. You can Google and then you will get more information about it.
Okay.
You may find some similar example the way you want to do. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Vidhi, you can send email to eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in for your attendance.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, the email address is given in the chat. Okay, any other general questions? So I was asking anybody, has anybody attempted a practice problem for the current tutorial? Did you get time to do that? If you finish watching it in the given time, and if you still have some 10 minutes, because so it is not really difficult problems we have given you. So you can, if you have time, you can try to attempt that. Okay, so you can do it in the evening, not an issue. But if you finish before time, just have a look at it.
Ma'am, while asking question, how do I upload the image? Like in the uploading image section, it is asking URL.
Okay.
Yes, Mr. Lokesh, I think you have tried to upload an image there. So it is showing some kind of gibberish, actually.
Yeah, instead of image, some I don't know what kind of code has been uploaded. Like,
so can you edit it, and instead of image, can you just copy and paste the code which you have used and the error which you have obtained, and okay, make sure that you use Control Shift V, pasting without formatting.
Okay. Okay.
Otherwise, it adds some kind of formats like bold and all italics. So just use Control Shift and V while pasting it.
Okay.
So if there are no other questions, we can take a lunch break. And after lunch break, everybody will join back here because we are going to have a live session on animation in R. It is going to be very interesting session. And that is, Digvijay is going to take care of that. So definitely you will see what all we can do in like 3D plotting and those things. Okay. We'll meet at 2 p.m. again. Yeah. Thank you.